Now let's take up the next question. It says, it's a very important and a very tricky question. You have to be really careful in this. It says a solid metal cylinder of 10 centimeter height and 14 centimeter diameter is melted in and recast into the two cones in the proportion of volume 3:4. Perfect. Keeping the height 10 centimeter. Oh, so the original height of the cylinder and the height of the new cones is also 10 centimeter. What would be the percentage change in the flat surface area? All right. So first, let's do one thing. First, let's calculate the volume of the original cylinder. The height is given as 10 centimeter. The diameter is given as 14 centimeter. But we don't need diameter. We need the radius. So the radius will be equal to half of 14, that is 7 centimeter. So the volume of cylinder can be calculated as pi r square h, right? Now the value of pi is 22 by 7, r is 7, so 7 square into h, that is 10. So simplify, one of the 7 gets cancelled, and in numerator we have 22 into 7, 154 into 10, that is 1540 centimeter cube, right? This is the total original volume. Now why I'm saying that, because when we melt and create something, when we melt, the volume remains constant. So the original volume, that is 1540 centimeter cube, should be equal to the total final volume. Now in the final case, there are two cones, right? There are two cones, and the ratio of the volume of the cones is 3:4. All right. So let's say the first cone is C1 and the second cone is C2. Then the volume of the first cone will be C1 equal to 3:4. So 3/7. Into 1540, a simple calculation, it is centimeter cube. So this will also be centimeter cube. So 7 cancels 1540, 220 times, 220 into 3, that is 660 centimeter cube. So the first one is 660 centimeter cube. Similarly, the second one, that will be equal to 4/7 into 1540 centimeter cube. 7 cancels 1540, 220 times, 220 into 4 is 880 centimeter cube. Right. So now we have the volumes of both the new cones. Okay. Now what do we have to do? Now we have to find the radii of the cones. Suppose the radius of the first cone is R1 and the radius of the second cone is R2. Height of both the cones is 10. Fantastic. It's given in the question already. Okay. Now the volume formula for the first cone can be written as 1/3 pi R1 square into H. And the C1 value, we have calculated 660. So let me put it here, it's equal to 660. Now it is 1/3 into pi is 22/7 into R1 square into H is 10. It is equal to 660. So 0 and 0 get cancelled. 22 cancels 66 3 times. So from here we have R1 square equal to 3 into 7, 21 into 3, that is 63. Let it be. No need to find R1. I'll tell you why. Because you have to find the area. In area, we'll always have R1 square. Similarly, from the second one, C2, the area formula will be 1/3 pi R2 square into H, which is equal to 880. Put the same values, like 1/3, pi will be 22/7 into R2 square into H is 10, that is equal to 880. Again, 0, 0 cancel. 22 cancels 88 4 times. 4 into 7 is 28 into 3, 84. So R2 square is equal to 84. Now, why am I doing this? Let's see. The question is saying, what would be the percentage change in the flat surface area? Now, please understand that in case of cylinder, the flat surface area is the circular surface. These two circular surfaces. So in a cylinder, there are two circular surfaces. And in a cone, this is the flat surface area. The other one is curved surface. Let's say one is for R1 and the other one will be for R2. Let's say this one is for R1 and this one is for R2. And this one was for R. This also was for R. So the original surface area, that will be for the cylinder. Original surface area will be for the cylinder. That will be 2 times the pi R square. Now the original R value is 7. Cylinder R value is 7. Right, so 7 if I put here, I'll get 49 into 2, 7 square is 49 into 2, 98 pi, let pi be as it is. And the new surface area, look at the new surface area. New surface area will be the area of the first cone, that is pi R1 square, plus area of the second cone, that is pi R2 square. Here we already have the values of R1 square and R2 square, that is 63 and 84. So if you add, pi comes out to be common, and inside we have r1 square plus r2 square, which is 63 plus 84. 63 plus 84 is equal to 147 pi. Right? So the original surface area was 98 pi. The new surface area is 147 pi. Right? I think we'll utilize this particular space here. So this is our initial value. This is our final value. Okay? And how do we calculate percentage change? Percentage change is equal to final minus initial divided by initial into 100. Here the final is 147, initial is 98. Now final minus initial, if you simply subtract, 147 minus 98 is 49. So it is 49 pi. Divide by initial is 98 pi into 100. Fantastic. So what do we have here? What we have here is pi and pi cancelled. 49 by 98 is 1 by 2. I'll not write, it is just, it'll be a little congested. 49 by 98 is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into 100 is 50%. Right? So the answer of this question is 50%. That is why it was a very, very tricky question. Right? The question was saying, question said that what would be the percentage change in the flat surface area before and after? So before it was cylinder. Cylinder has two surfaces. Right? And after it was cone, and there would be two different cones. So you have to be a little careful here. The answer of the question is 50%. Okay. Now let's take up the next question. Now this is a very interesting question. It says a square sheet of paper is converted into a cylinder by rolling it along its length. Now how do you roll a square sheet? Let's see. I am sure all of us one time in our childhood we would have done this. The square sheet is folded like this to create a cylindrical shape. Right? So what happens? The total area of the sheet becomes the curved surface of the cylinder. So area of the original sheet is equal to the curved surface area of cylinder. Right? You can just memorize this also. Okay? So if I take the side as A, then this total circumference of the circle will be equal to A. So if I take the radius to be R, 2 pi R should be equal to A. Alright, so we can also calculate R from here in terms of A. Look at the question, what is it saying? What is the ratio of the base radius of cylinder to the side of the square? Oh, so we just need to find R is to A. So from here only, R by A is equal to 1 by 2 pi. Look at the options. If this is the option, this is the answer. That's it. Or if you need to simplify, do that. It is 1 by 2 into 22 by 7. So 7 goes up, it becomes 7 divided by 44. So the answer is 7 is to 44. Be careful about the order of presentation. It says base radius of cylinder, that is R, and the side of square, that is A. So R is to A, we have to calculate. We have to memorize that when we roll, then the side length becomes equal to the circumference of the base circle of the cylinder. Okay. Now let's go to the next question. It says the volume of a cylinder which has a height of 7 meters and a base radius of 2 meters. Right. So cylinder volume directly we know. Is the formula is pi r square h. Put the values here. Pi is 22 by 7. R is given 2 meters. So 2 square into h is given 7 meters. So 7 and 7 are cancelled. 2 square is 4. 4 into 22 is 88. Now this question again, the direct formula based question. Curved surface area of a cylinder. Length is 7 meter. Length means height. Right? Length of a cylinder means height of the cylinder. 7 meter. And base radius 4 meter. So radius is 4 meter. And the curved surface area of a cylinder, is equal to 2 pi rh. This is the direct formula for that, right? Put the value. So it is 2 into pi is 22 by 7, r is 4, h is 7. So 7 and 7 are cancelled. 2 into 22 is 44 into 4, that is equal to 176 meter square. All right. So this question was a direct question based on a formula. Okay. Curved surface area of a cylinder, 2 pi rh. Okay. Now the next question. Find the volume of the cone whose slant height is 17 centimeter and the radius of base is 8 centimeter. So slant height, let's say first, let's draw the cone. This is a cone, right? The radius is r. Okay. This is the center. Radius is r. The height is h and the slant height is this one, l. And the relation between them is L square should be equal to H square plus R square according to the Pythagoras theorem. This is the relation between them for a cone, right? Here it is given that slant height L is 17 centimeter, right? And the radius of base is R, which is 8 centimeter. So first we have to find H from here. As you can see from here, H square will be equal to L square minus R square, right? Or you can directly memorize the Pythagorean triplet, that is 8, 15, 17. 15 is missing here, so obviously H will be 15. The other two sides are given. Or if you don't remember this triplet, you can use this. H square will be equal to L square, that is 17 square, minus R square, that is 8 square. Now 17 square is 289. Minus 8 square is 64, which is 225. So we have H square equal to 225, which is 15 square. That gives us H is equal to 15 centimeter. Now why are we doing that? Because the question is saying volume of the cone. And the volume of the cone is calculated as, the direct formula is 1 by 3 pi r square h. Put the values here, 1 by 3 into pi is 22 by 7 into r square. Now what is r square? It is 8 square and h is 15. So just calculate all these values. So 3 cancels 15 5 times. 5 into 8 square. Now 64 into 5 is 320. 320 into 22. 704. So it becomes 7040 divided by 7. If you simplify, if you simply divide, it will be equal to 1000, and 40 by 7 is 5. So 1005.7 centimeter cube. Alright, so this should be the answer. But you must check whether the option is given in terms of pi. In that case, we will not take this one. We'll just put pi here. In that case, it will be equal to 8 square is 64 into 5, 320 pi. Alright, so depends on the option. If in terms of pi, if it is given, it is 320 pi. If we put the value of pi, it will be 1005.7 centimeter cube. Alright, now let's go to the next question. Now, this question says, curved surface area of a cone is 1760 square centimeter. The radius of its base is 8 centimeter. Find its height. Clear? The curved surface area of a cone is directly given as, curved surface of a cone. The formula is pi r l. Right, here the value is 1760, curved surface area value is given as 1760 equal to pi is 22 by 7 into radius is given as 8, all right, and L we can calculate from here, right, you can simplify, 22 cancels 1760 straight away 80 times, right, because 22 8 times is 176, and then finally 8 cancels 80 10 times. So 10 and this 7 goes to the other side. 10 into 7 is 70. So L is equal to 70 centimeter. Alright. We have to find the height. Now here height will be a tricky thing because we know the formula is L square is equal to H square plus R square. We have L, that is 70. So 70 square is equal to H square plus R square is simply 8 square. Oh. So 70 square is 4900 minus 8 square is 64 is equal to H square. So we have H square equal to 4900 minus 64 is 4836. Don't worry about it, whatever the value you get. So H is equal to square root of 4836, which is approximately equal to 69.5 centimeter. Alright. Now let's take up the next question. The circumference of the base of 12 meter high conical tent is 66 meter. Find the volume of the air contained in it. So basically the volume of air is volume itself, the volume of cone. So we have to find the volume of cone, right? The height is given as 12 meter and the circumference of base is given as 66 meter, right? So first let me draw the conical tent, right? This is the conical tent. This base radius is R. The base circumference will be 2 pi R and that is given as 66. So it is 2 into pi is 22 by 7 into r, that is equal to 66. Now 22 cancels 66 3 times. So r is equal to 7 threes are 21 by 2 meter. Let it be. Okay. Height is already given 12 meter. Okay. So the volume of cone will be calculated as, formula is 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay. So let's put the values here. 1 by 3 into pi is 22 by 7. Into r square is 21 by 2 square into h is 12. All right. So just to open it, it will be 22 into 21 into 21 into 12 whole divided by, denominator will be 3 into 7 into 2 into 2. All right. Now 7 cancels one of the 21 3 times. Now this 3 and 3 are cancelled. 2 cancels 12 6 times and 2 cancels again 6 3 times. So what are we left with? We are left with the volume equal to 22 into 21 into 3. This is one place where a lot of people make mistakes. So be careful. It is 22 into 21 into 3. Multiply it carefully, which is equal to 1386. And unit is meter cube. So the volume of air is equal to the volume of cone. It is equal to 1386 meter cube. Alright. Now let's go to the next question.